Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kite, and I'm going to do a slightly faster one. Every now and again, what I'm going to do is, because I've got two schools of thought that go along with me. I've got some that go, tell, do some quick ones. We want, you know, you ramble on, you know, which I do. And then there's other people that go, it's so nice to sit down with someone that just relaxes and chats to you about beer. Now that's what I like. I like to sit and but anyway, I'm going to have to speed up and start going quicker. Let's go. Bop. The Americans, when I talk quick like this, they can't understand the word I'm saying. Sorry. Right, let's go. Now, try to keep the voice nice and slow. That is the Grand Cru. R. And that R stands for Rodenbach. I'm not going to tell you all about the brewery and everything else. There's the thingy. All that business. Let's pour it and share it. That is what it looks like. That is the colour through the thing. And just behind there is the colour that you're getting through the glass. Just on there in that shadow. A little reflection. Right. On the nose I'm getting dried strawberries, currants, syrupy sort of molasses, and a bit of maple syrup even. And prunes. A tiny little hint of something like a bergamot orange. And I am going in. Cheers. Cool. Wow. Wow. I don't know if this has gone soured. But if it has, it's gone soured in a lovely, lovely way. I kind of think that this has gone soured, but it's delicious. It really is delicious. I've had beers that have soured up before. This has kind of gone bready in it. It's gone a little bit. Oh wow, that is lovely. What? Let's have a look. See if I can read anything on this. Where's my magnifier? Grand Cru. Oh yeah, sweet sour taste. Wow. Right, Grand Cru is an exceptional Belgian brew known as the Flemish red brown beer. A mixed fermentation beer, Rodenbach Grand Cru is matured in oak vats, giving it a sweet sour taste and intense bouquet. With a very long aftertaste, like a Grand Cru wine. Rodenbach Grand Cru is a blend of young beer, 1/3, and beer that is matured for over 2 years, 2/3. That is really spectacular. That is glorious. And it took me quite by surprise because I was expecting, I didn't read up on it and was expecting kind of all sorts of thick and kind of like those Belgian doubles almost or something like that. And it went slap, get hold of that. And it's kind of bittered in a glorious way. The only time I think I've had something similar was the last time I had Christmas crack was out in the garden here in the summertime, would you believe? And it had bittered slightly and gone a bit bready and a bit kind of, a bit sour. And it was lovely still. It was absolutely glorious. And it had gone sweet but sour as well. And this has gone the same way. Kind of lovely. Oh, wow. Right, it's like, God, that's really weird. really, really weird and glorious. See if I can pick this apart for you now. It's a slight... if you've ever had strawberries and strawberries and balsamic vinegar with a bit of sugar over them, that's very similar to what you've got going on here. You've got those sweet, vinegary sort of things going on, those sour sort of tastes and things. A little bit of almost a note of sweet and sour sauce that you get in the Chinese, isn't it? Oh wow, that's lovely. It's going again. Very weird. Very, very weird. Almost like a fruit juice in there. Kind of, it's like a prune juice mixed with lemon juice. It's a bit like that, but with a beery, with a background of something like a, as if you've mixed a strong kind of imperial stout in there as well, mixed in with a lemon juice and a bit of prune juice in there. That's cool. Oh, wow, that's weird. Oh, I like that. I really, really, really like that. I really like that. That's going to be a big acquired taste. It really is. That took me by surprise, and I love being taken by surprise with a beer. That is lovely. Let's see what's going on yeast-wise. Don't look like a lot in the bottle yeast-wise, but I'm putting the cap back on the bottle there. That is, I'm going to save that one until later and frighten the missus with it. That's lovely. That really is lovely. Right. You're going to be a bit shocked by it. You're not going to be sure of how to take it. You may hate it and you may love it. Personally, I love it. Try it, buy it. Definitely try and buy it, without a doubt. But try and buy it and like it, I'd say. Pardon me. But it's up to you whether you like it. It's going to be one of Marmite beers, I think. I love it. I really do. That is glorious. That really is. Cheers. Bottoms up. Nostrovia.